In simple terms, ovulation is the release of mature eggs from one of your ovaries, which usually happens every menstrual cycle. Think of your ovaries as a crate of an egg with thousands of eggs. Each month, about 6 to 12 starts to mature, but usually only one becomes dominant and is released. The egg then travels down to the fallopian tubes where it can be fertilized by the sperm. So why is ovulation so important? I'll give you three. The first one is for conception. When you and your partner want to make a baby today, ovulation is the main event that both of you must attend. An egg can only be fertilized within 12 to 24 hours after being released. So knowing when you ovulate helps to identify your most fertile days. Secondly, knowing when you ovulate serves as your natural family planning. For some of you that do not want to make use of other contraceptive methods or family planning methods out there, like use of condoms for a reason best known to you, I don't want to get into that, or other contraceptive medication because of the side effects of getting fat and the rest, resolving to time in your ovulation will serve as a natural family planning for you. Although you have to stick till the end of the video to know how to calculate your ovulation period so as to maximize and reduce the risk of an error. Thirdly, knowing about your ovulation helps you to understand your cycle. You see, it's not all about trying to get pregnant or trying to avoid pregnancy. Rather, knowing about ovulation helps you as a woman to understand your reproductive health, because it's a signal that your reproductive hormones, your female sexual hormones, are actually working appropriately. Because irregular or absent ovulation can sometimes be a sign that there's an underlying what, health issue that might need an attention. So the knowledge of ovulation will help you to understand how your reproductive cycle is, how is your reproductive hormone responding at appropriate time of the month. So after knowing the importance of ovulation, the best question will be, what are the signs that yes, my ovulatory period is close by, or I am even currently ovulating, right? We get a lot of this question. But just like your phone sends notification when your man's promised to send money and he eventually sends it, your body also sends these clues when you are about to ovulate or when you're even ovulating, just that you don't pay attention to these clues. Here are some of the signs that your body is trying to let you know that you're about to ovulate or you're even ovulating. Number one, increased sexual drive. It's not all part of the months that your sexual drive is high or low, but when your body is about to ovulate, some days prior to your ovulatory period, you find an increased urge for sex. This is only to stimulate you to have sexual intercourse, whereby sperm actually lasts for maximum 5 days. So days prior to your ovulatory, you will have high sexual urge and might demand for sex during those periods for fertilization. Secondly, you will experience breast tenderness, whereby some women complain that they feel the breast is full and it's a little bit painful. This is because of the hormonal surge that happens prior to ovulation. Thirdly, you might experience an increased sense of taste or smell, whereby you feel like you could smell everything, or your sense of smell is actually heightened prior to ovulation. The fourth is the least ignored, though the most reliable changes you will feel while you are about to ovulate or when you're ovulating, which is the changes in your cervical mucus. As you approach ovulation or while ovulating, you will discover that your vaginal discharges typically become clearer, more slippery and stretcher like a raw egg white. This cervical mucus helps sperm to swim and also survive. You might notice that when you go to the bathroom or on your underwears when you're trying to change them. A lot of you do not pay close attention to such changes, or maybe feel like, okay, they are just secretions. No, you have to pay very close attention to those changes, because it's indicating to you that, okay, you are about to ovulate or you are even currently even ovulating. The fifth change that you will notice while ovulating is a rise in your basal body temperature. So your basal body temperature is the temperature of your body while fully at rest. And research has shown that while ovulating, it is slightly what? Elevated to about 0.2 to 0.5 degrees Celsius changes, and it stays elevated until your next period. How to track this is you will need a basal thermometer where you take your temperature first thing in the morning before you get out of your bed, and chart this daily, because this is going to help you to see the pattern and confirm the changes while ovulating.